K105.com via the Apple and Android smartphone app using the SoundCloud, iTunes, or Spotify podcast on
Facebook, on
YouTube, on Twitter. And the hashtag is in the know. Coming up today, we're going to update you on the latest news headlines from around the community, the county, the Commonwealth, and the country. Plus, we will give you a chance to win. It's day number 13 of Where's Quacky. We'll tell you about that and a whole lot more coming up today here on In the Know. Settling into my left, rolling monitor,
nine with her
hair on fire, and my beautiful wife, the beautiful girl. It's Beach. Good morning, sweetheart.
Good morning.
How you doing?
I'm okay.
Have you seen the something? You're quiet over there.
Yeah, there's
something. Pull it closer. There you go.
Right.
That's right. Have you seen?
Sent it to you last night, and I don't know if you checked your email. Have you seen the the
special treasure at the zoo in Tennessee? So it is a giraffe that is being called a one-of-a-kind spotless giraffe born at a Tennessee zoo.
It's in northeast Tennessee, and it's a community called Limestone.
Now, if you were to be able to have one pet giraffe, only one,
Okay. Would
you rather have a one like this, or would you rather have the normal reticulated, normally spotted kind?
As much as I love this sweet little thing, and he is so unique, I think I would want the spotted.
I mean, because you don't necessarily look at this and think giraffe,
no,
because of without the pattern.
But I love it.
But did you know you can also vote to name this
know
creature?
That.
Okay,
So is it a boy or a girl? I didn't read that.
I didn't read that.
Okay.
Yet to be named. Only one of her kind. That's what I said. One of her kind. So
a little girl.
So Joffrey won't work. So he is a 5-time winner of the coveted Ohio News Hawk Award. He's the 2-time Silver Sow nominee, covering every corner of the globe: London, Budapest, Rio, Tokyo, and even Litchfield. He's Sam Gormley. Oh, not too bad.
You know, when you get out of your routine, things seem to be swimming upstream. You know, when you get things out of order. You've had an out-of-order morning, and I've had an out-of-order morning, so it's like, oh, yes, feels like in a
constant rush.
No question about that.
You may be the biggest consumer of, hand sanitizer in the building.
Probably.
Fair to say?
Then again, I'm in the building more than anyone else.
That's fair to say as well.
So per capita, yes.
How often do you, and collectively, then I'm going to ask I, wash the wristband of our smartwatch?
Ooh.
No, I mean, I will shower in it sometime. Like, well, I don't know how often, but, and then when that happens, it just, like, the process.
Right.
Goes along.
The alcohol preps to mine. Mine is light in color and gets, well, all the things that I do, but it gets quite dirty. So I use alcohol preps on the band of mine.
This says, a study says 95% of watch wristbands are contaminated with bacteria. So, you know, we worry about our hands somewhat, but we don't really worry about our wrist collects a lot of, let's say, that's a sweat point, you know, it just gets grimy on there. So occasionally you got to go in there and, like you say, you can put it in waterproof mode, and you can, you know, shower with it or dump it in water. I have two Apple Watches. I have one that's like a work watch, and then one is like an everyday dressier watch. But I finally put the sport one, the work one, in the water this summer.
Like, oh, you've never done that before?
I was in a pool, and I never had really needed to. Like, I hadn't, it hadn't been necessity, and it does work. Yeah, I was like, hey, look, this still works. So anyway, spend a little time getting the watch band clean when you can. The heat wave is going to continue, but fortunately today it will not be as humid as we experienced yesterday. It will be a brief respite before we get hotter tomorrow and more humid again tomorrow. But today, a little bit of a break, but now you might not notice it that much, but it will be marginally better. We're going to see the excessive heat warnings and heat advisories. There's a combination of those depending upon where you are regionally on whether you have a warning or an advisory, and they're continuing to monitor those things. I do not see any way that on Friday that high school football and other sports that might be playing on Friday afternoon do not get, or golf or anything, that they do not get pushed back beyond their scheduled start time because of the heat that's going to remain
on
in
that,
the atmosphere.
On that note, it sounds like a decision on that. Since obviously they want to make a decision, it's not like they're playing Edmondson County where theoretically Edmondson can easily, since you're playing Marshall, a decision needs to be made a little bit ahead of time. I would expect one, if not this afternoon, early tomorrow.
Yeah, it's the biggest hardship for Marshall County.
Yes.
Because they're the traveling team. We're just, if we start late, well, no big deal. We were here all
day. Or even if it was Edmondson County or Breckenridge County making the trip, it's very easy for them to say, okay, well, we'll just come 30 minutes later.
That's right. Yeah, it's a little more difficult. But sunny today, high of, I think we'll see 94 here between the lakes. Partly cloudy, 77 tonight. Partly cloudy, very hot tomorrow, high of 98. And then 99 on Friday, and then we get a little bit of a step down on Saturday, and even more mild on Sunday. And, of course, next week the big FAIR will roll into town, and temperatures look pretty good for that. Though right now the weather looks nice, especially the second half of the week. Looks like clear. If you have been anxiously awaiting the first GOP presidential debate tonight, there's a treat for you. The first debate among Republicans is on Fox tonight. It starts at 8 o'clock Central Time, being moderated by Fox News Channel hosts Brett Baer and Martha McCallum. The Trump train will not be there. The Trump is sitting out. And they also, Fox kind of held them. They're not allowing any of their campaign people, their spinners, anybody to be part of the debate. They said if you're not participating in the debate, you're not participating in the debate. It will be interesting to see if anybody gets traction tonight. If, you know, kind of goes DeSantis, then Ramaswamy, and then on down from there. Be interesting to see if anybody stands out tonight.
I just find it funny that, you know, like we're watching it here. It's like the NFL draft. Like all of the, they've got like the preview show, and they got all the experts coming on. And it's like, who's going to be number one pick?
And if it's interesting, if you look over Brett Baer's left shoulder for their graphic, it almost reminds me of the Lombardi Trophy. Like, there's something about that silver kind of color that's like, oh, yeah, they're really trying to pump this thing up. And, of course, I mean, it's their debate, so they're trying to pull out all the stops. But there's not any new television on tonight, so might as well, if you got any interest, you can watch it. There was a gas leak in Litchfield last night, spurred action by multiple first responding groups, including Litchfield Utilities. The LPD, about 9:20 last night, responded to the 300 block of West White Oak Street. Residents had called dispatch and said there was a smell of natural gas in the area. The LPD officers also detected the same. They got the fire department and utilities to the scene. They found a gas leak coming from an underground valve at the intersection of West White Oak and South Broadway. They fixed that valve and finished that up about 11:30. Last night, the Litchfield City Council met earlier in the week, and Mayor Harold Miller announced that they have hired a longtime maintenance supervisor for Grayson County, Scotty Cantway, who will be helping the city. He's been hired to oversee operations and safety aspects, a lot of OSHA-type things, safety procedures, things of that nature. So Scotty familiar to that type of work. They discussed possible closure of an alleyway on West Main Street. They discussed a public works employee shortage. They are in big need of filling some vacancies there. And then handed out some beautification awards as well. So anyway, there's apparently some type of litigation they're involved in with a trial date setting in February. So after a executive session, that was the word out of that session. So anyway. A body has been found in a wooded area of Hardin County. The Hardin County Sheriff's Office, Radcliffe Police, and State Police worked a wooded area off Homestead Avenue near Rineyville Road, where they found a decomposing body near a creek bed. They also found a backpack nearby. It is a male. The cause of death has not yet been determined. They do believe they have identified the subject, but pending notifications and confirmation of that, they have not yet released the identity of that individual. Kentucky handed out its first licenses to horse tracks to operate sports betting facilities yesterday, and allows for companies to accept online bets, paving the way for legal wagering on sporting events to start next month. The action by the Kentucky Horse Racing Commission means bettors now know where they can place in-person sports wagers starting September 7 and which mobile applications can take wagers beginning September 28. So it's been a really accelerated schedule throughout the summer. Once that was passed by the General Assembly, then try to get that in line for the launch of, in particular, the NFL season. But they'll be up and running by week two of the college football season.
I'm really interested. So it came out this morning that the governor is going to make the first bet.
He is. I thought Drew Franklin was going to do that.
Yeah. Well, but I'm really interested for him. Like, what do you bet on?
Yeah.
Like, can he?
You can't make the first bet and keep it a secret.
Well, but still, it's like, can he bet on Kentucky to win? Because then the U of L fans would be upset.
That's exactly
or does
right.
he go and like bet on the Washington State, you know, football game or something? I'd be interested.
Don't weasel out. Come on, make a bold bet.
Yeah, I'm interested to see what he does. Maybe he'll parlay something.
So each racetrack gets a satellite facility. So Churchill Downs gets Louisville, Derby City Gaming in Louisville. Ellis Park gets the Mint Gaming Hall Cumberland Run. And then you got something. You got a Mint Gaming Hall in Cumberland. That's around, Corbin? Mm-hmm. Then you got Newport Racing and Gaming in Newport. You get Oak Grove Gaming and Racing at Oak Grove. The Red Mile and Turfway Park in Florence. They all get a satellite location. And, again, I think there's going to be one in Owensboro.
I think that's Ellis Park's satellite will be in Owensboro.
Ellis Park satellite.
Yes.
Okay. And it will be out in the county, if you recall.
Yeah.
They were trying to put it in Owensboro, and the Churchill Downs Incorporated said that Owensboro didn't want to play ball with them, so they went out in the county. The Kentucky Community and Technical College System joined Governor Beshear at a press conference yesterday at the state capitol to announce a new program known as the Education First Initiative. Under the program, students join participating companies and work while also attending classes, enabling them to earn a living while receiving an education to help them improve their pay potential. Governor called it a sea change in how we go about workforce development. So, anyway, you might be hearing more about that, especially from our friends at KCTCS and ECTC. Good news, the UPS workers did approve the 5-year contract, avoiding a potential strike. It felt like it had been turned away, but until it was ratified by the membership, there was still some doubt. But 86% of the votes cast were in favor of ratifying the national contracts, so the boys and girls in brown looks like they will not be slowing down the deliveries to your front porch. The federal government has awarded, they awarded $1.5 billion to cover the cost of the Brent Spence Bridge Corridor project that is much needed there between Covington and Cincinnati, and now Kentucky and Indiana are hoping for a similar grant from the federal government. Kentucky and Indiana are jointly applying for $632 million in federal funds for the Interstate 69 Ohio River Crossing Project linking Henderson and Evansville. That section, technically the U.S. 41 bridge, begins and ends in Kentucky.
Yeah, because Ellis Park is, geographically is pretty much Indiana, right?
Geographically, Ellis Park is in Indiana, but technically it's in Kentucky because the river route changed after the state boundaries were formed due to an earthquake. The new bridge is being considered. If you go down, I think they're going to consider avoiding the U.S. 41 strip in Henderson and going east of it, and then going straight across the Ohio River there and connecting with what would be Indiana, with a section that would regain where Indiana would be on one side of the bridge and Kentucky on the other. So there are a couple of different proposals that they're making for that bridge route, but my guess is they've selected that one. At least it's not just going to go beside the old U.S. 41 bridge. It will be a new path. One of the problems with that route that I just told you about is that's where John James Audubon State Park is east of U.S. 41 in that area. So I don't know if they would go through it, go around it, go over it, under it. Probably not going under it. Probably aren't going over it, but we'll see. Western Kentucky University looks like the team to beat as Conference USA kicks off with 4 new members. So the Conference USA landscape has changed a little bit. Charlotte's gone. UAB's gone. North Texas is gone. Florida Atlantic, Rice, and UTSA all gone from Conference USA.
That sounds about right.
So that leaves the five.
It's just WKU. You know the Will Smith meme of him standing in the open room looking around. I think it's from Fresh Prince.
Oh, yeah.
That's pretty much what Western was like.
When everybody moves.
Uh-huh.
They bring in Sam Houston, Liberty, New Mexico State,
and Jacksonville State for this year. They're going to add Kennesaw State for next year, but it looks like Western is the creme de la creme of the football slate. So expecting Coach Helton to do big things.
Yeah, yeah. It should be exciting. They open up the year next week against South Florida. So hopefully they can pick up a big win there.
Are they the Bulls?
They are.
South Florida Bulls.
South Florida Bulls is who they got.
We have been, each day over the last week or so, there's a news story in the news cycle about UK football. And today it's Dane Key's turn. They're talking, interview with Dane
was it
Key.
By Ryan Lemon?
It was by, it was promoted by Ryan Lemon. He says, Dane says he's happy to have Liam Cohen back. Liam Cohen is one of the things that brought Dane Key to Lexington, but then Liam Cohen bolted for the Rams, and then Key came in for Scangarello and probably didn't have the freshman season that he was expecting to have, but he did catch 37 passes for 519 yards and 6 touchdowns last year, but is going to be a very important part of the offense alongside Berrion Brown. And they got a pretty good receiver room, so they'll be looking to do big things. But his brother, I know his dad's Dante. His brother is
Devin.
Devin, right.
He's on the Broncos.
Broncos right now? I know he was on the Chiefs for a while. He's kind of bounced around.
Yes, because I know Ryan Lemon is on my side of anti-Chiefs now, so it's good.
Oh, anti-Chiefs. I got
you. Because he's anti-Chiefs because they cut him. So, I'm pretty sure he's on the Broncos. I don't know that he'll make the team or not. It might shock you. I'm not really an expert in the Broncos safety room.
Dante, where did he play?
Franklin Simpson.
Franklin Simpson. Yeah, very good. Got to get to a break. We'll come back. Day number 13 of Where's Quacky? You may be the next winner. We'll tell you about it coming up here on In the Know.
Owensboro Health offers excellent care for your entire family. Close to home in Grayson County with locations in Litchfield, Big Clifty, and Caneyville. Our primary care providers are experts in managing high blood pressure, diabetes, and other chronic conditions, so you can stay healthy and feel your best. Make an appointment today with one of our primary care providers at owensborohealth.org/primary care.
Something's on fire! Quick, put it out!
Oh, it's filled with... Ew!
Ew! Look, there's a note! Humans, stop leaving your pet waste on the ground. It washes down the storm drain and straight into our water. We're sick of it. Signed, The Fish?
It's time we all did our part to stop polluting Kentucky's waterways. To find out how you can help, visit stormwater.ky.gov. Brought to you by the Kentucky Transportation Cabinet.
Beach Bend Park. That's where my summer happens.
It's where my family's come for generations for great times.
It's where amusement rides and water park slides are just my size.
It's where my friends and I have a blast on the big thrill rides.
It's where we can do all the attractions and not spend time in long lines.
Beach Bend Park has something for everyone, from classic amusement attractions the whole family can enjoy, children's rides, to big, fast, sky-reaching thrill rides. Plus, cool off with Splash Lagoon Water Park, where you can relax in the lazy river, ride the waves, and take the plunge on slides from mile to wild. Come to Beach Bend Park to create some memories, including fireworks, back for Friday Night Lights in July. It's where you can have unlimited thrills with a 2023 season pass for just $74.99 with unlimited visits, a free souvenir cup, 2 anytime bring a friend free tickets, discounts, and more. For daily specials, birthday parties, and hours, visit beachbend.com.
Quality paves the way. That's the motto of Scotty's Contracting and Stone. All of the crushed stone products from Scotty's Quarry in Litchfield are mined underground. Scotty's Contracting and Paving provides cleaner products made from pure limestone. If you agree that quality makes the difference, contact the team at Scotty's Contracting and Stone for crushed stone products for your project at 259-5696. That's 259-5696. Our quarry is located on Quarry Road in Litchfield.
Are you looking for the best building materials in Litchfield? Look no further than Future Designs Building Materials. The Builder's Choice on Quarry Road has everything you need to build your dream home. Jim writes, "I'm so glad I came to Future Designs for my new roof. The staff was so helpful and knowledgeable, and they made sure I got the right materials for my needs. Thanks, Jim. Future Designs is more than just a building materials store. Future Designs Building Materials on Quarry Road in Litchfield. FDBM.net.
Building on experience.
X is planning to remove the automatically populated headlines from Newslinks. Elon Musk says the change will improve aesthetics. When the new look is active, a post will simply display the link and the header image. Autonomous vehicle software company Plus AI is collaborating with an Australian company to bring self-driving trucks to that country. They're working on the Trans-Suburban's automated freight program. The goal is to reduce the number of vehicles on the highway and to... That's according to The Hill, which reports that parent company Yum Brands said in an earnings call this month that it plans to move to 100% digital sales at its restaurants, which also include Pizza Hut and KFC. That means customers would order through apps, websites, or in-store kiosks. In an interview with the CFO Journal, the company's CFO said it's already testing AI to take drive-through orders. Tech Report, Mark Mayfield.
Today is Hug Your Sweetheart Day. It is Buttered Corn Day.
I do like that.
And I remember the last few days of July, I went ahead and prepared you that today is Ride the Wind Day. Don't be breaking it. Ride it. You can ride the wind by flying in an airplane. You can fly a kite. You could parachute. You could bungee jump, you could hang glide, you could ride in a motorcycle or ride a motorcycle, you could hop in a sailboat. Those are all ways you could ride the wind. Reminds me of, we had a cistern out behind the house that I grew up on, in, and the end of the cistern had a drop-off of about 4 feet, maybe, 3 feet, something, but then that led to a hill that went down to the driveway, et cetera. So it was kind of an elevation change quickly. And I remember thinking, if I could just run fast enough with a bed sheet off the end of the cistern and jump, I might be able to parachute down to the driveway. But
how'd that work out for you?
I never was able to do it. I don't. It's probably just because I wasn't able to run fast enough.
You're never too old.
That's true. I mean, Looney Tunes led me to believe...
Lots of
physics like that were possible.
You just levitate in the air for a couple of seconds while doing it.
Sure.
Too.
Listen, but
do
as
not
long...
put him up to anything. I'm the one who'll have to take care of him when it crashes and burns.
Well, we can just make sure Alea's there filming it.
Oh, okay.
Sure.
Mm-hmm. So that we have the video.
And everyone knows, so long as you don't look down, you won't fall. But the moment you're out there levitating, if you look down, you're going
to fall.
We can even
edit it and, you know, put some cartoon eyes, you know, when you realize you're about to fall. And...
Oh, get the TikTok treatment.
Uh-huh.
Today
floating
is
head.
Day number 13 of Where's Quacky? Be your chance to win. Miss Buckles over there has been whipping everybody into shape this morning because she knew that yesterday I had to have some real talk with everybody. I was extremely disappointed with the behavior of people as it pertained to sponsoring ducks. So we've seen some movement this morning, and we're hoping that...
I will say, too, that the colonel texted me later, and one Yukon Cornelius did go through and purchase his ducks.
Okay. Good.
So he wasn't full of it in just talking.
Good. Well, so my post this morning, I want to brag on my husband. It shows my new license plate. It's Donate a Life. Anyway, and I absolutely love it. I'm not asking you to donate tissues, organs, or even blood today, because sometimes I will ask you.
It would be okay with you if you did.
Yes, absolutely.
But that's not what you're asking.
But I'm asking today for you to go and sponsor a duck. So far, this morning, just from this post, 6 ducks have been sponsored.
And that's just been about, what, an hour?
An hour,
something
maybe.
Like that.
And tomorrow, I'm going to start calling you out on Facebook.
By the way, if we just did six an hour,
right?
You say if we could just get six sponsored an hour, we would have them all sponsored by the time the Ducking Hunger Regatta gets here.
And I'm just going to tell some of you all, I'm in a lot of buy-sell groups on Facebook. I see what you're buying.
Oh, yeah.
I'm going to need you to fork over $5.
You're also in a lot of stores in town, and you see what people are spending their money on. You know they got $5 to sponsor a duck. Absolutely.
So, I'm going to start calling you out, too.
Especially if you think you could turn it into $1,000.
Right?
I mean, come on.
Or it means second and third prize gets... You know, aquatic center passes too, I mean,
that's not
just
nothing.
As good.
That's not, it might, if you went often enough, it might be worth more than $1,000. Alan Tabor knew that Quacky spent the day at the tailwater of Nolin Dam yesterday.
You can tell, what a good day to be out there in the
water.
It
was a great day and such a beautiful area. Now, if you have been to both tailwaters on both of our lakes, then you would be able to know that there are certain characteristics of Rough River as compared to Nolin and the tailwater. If you've been to neither, you could have taken a 50-50 shot and known
Is that the dam in the background?
That is the dam in the background. Yes, that is. And so you'll see that riprap rock that's around like in one level, and then that steps on up, and then that would be the roadway at the very top. So the Rough River version, you would not see... You would be much less likely to see a photograph from this side of the tailwater where Quacky is. But now Quacky could just swim across with his duck iPhone and take it.
My comment machine's broken today, but the colonel just wrote in there and said Quacky apparently loves riding the wind. So
Of course.
What a perfect.
That's right. So
you ready for today's?
Congratulations, Alan. Thanks for playing. You've got your own duck in the Ducking Hunger Regatta. And you might win $1,000, but you have for sure helped encourage others to sponsor ducks and help raise up to 80,000 meals for the Grayson County Alliance. Day number 13, where's Quacky? This photograph is on our Facebook page.
I think I actually know this one.
And you will just tell us where Quacky is spending the day. Now, you know, I'm a detail-oriented person, so I think I know what the correct answer is, but I'm saying depending upon a matter of a few feet might make a difference on the location, is all I'm saying. I can't see where Quacky's webbed feet are actually standing. If I knew where Quacky's feet were actually standing, it might change my answer.
Because he could be with Kevin Henderson right now.
He could be hovering. He could be, I don't know. So there you go. You may be the next winner of Where's Quacky. And there's the QR code. If you're watching, then please point your phone at it. And it's easy to do. $5 per duck. We had a friend in Ohio County pick up just four ducks this morning.
I know, right?
Just like, here's four ducks.
I love it.
So it works out great. There's the QR code. More than three decades after it first called for the end of corporal punishment in schools, the American Academy of Pediatrics is having to repeat itself amid the ongoing hitting of students. Corporal punishment, defined as the infliction of pain upon a person's body, is punishment, and it should be abolished in all states by law, according to updated policy from the group of 67,000 pediatricians. All right, so my point is not to disagree with the philosophy. But I more have a question. Are we still having a high level of corporal punishment in schools?
I didn't think so.
Well, there was the bill that was going through the state legislature in the last couple of years, right?
Yeah, I think so.
To ban it officially.
I just thought that probably, at least in Kentucky, that...
Now, was it prevalent when you were like...
Oh, absolutely.
Are you kidding?
How often did you get the ruler across the knuckles?
On the receiving end.
I never got a ruler. I got paddled twice in school in all of my years. It was twice. I know three times. One of them, because I still maintain one of them, I was innocent. I was guilty of being in the wrong crowd at the wrong time, but I had not committed the infraction. But I got drugged.
Did you deserve the other two?
Yes, I definitely deserve the other two, without a doubt. But yeah, it was a total of three times, and it was spread out. It was like fourth grade, fifth grade, and then it was senior year. Because we had
you
gave
got
us
paddled your senior year. Of
well,
high school.
If you'd known what we had done, you would have understood.
Did you deserve it that year?
Absolutely. We took the lesser. We took the lesser of the punishments that were provided to us, and that was paddling.
You're not going to share the story now.
So who did like? What size of person did the paddling?
Oh, my dear friend Charlie Crane.
Okay, so he could still put some fear in some seniors.
Oh, yeah, without a doubt.
Got it.
Yeah,
okay.
No. We were taller than Teddy White by then, but we were not taller than Charlie Crane.
Okay.
So all nobody's right. taller than Charlie Crane. So, yeah, that's what happened.
You're not going to say as to what the reasoning was? Statute of limitations is passed, right?
Oh, absolutely. We just probably weren't somewhere we should have been when we were supposed to be there.
Oh, hooky.
It was just as simple as that.
And he's lucky that's just the one time he got caught.
Well, I mean, that was probably, that probably covered several times. But, yeah.
Well, I really hope he whipped you all hard.
Oh, he did. He did. But in my day, Sam, the paddles were hanging on the walls. They were just designed to remind you this can happen to you if you misbehave or step out of line. So just the fact of knowing it could happen, a lot of the time would deter the behavior to begin with. So it didn't have to be used.
When I was in school, I loved him. Our PE teacher in elementary school, bless his heart, I to this day love him dearly. His had holes in the wooden paddles so that the wind could go through, you know, go through. Yes.
More force.
Mm-hmm. I think that was the case with this one too.
But and maybe that was common, but
it was over pretty quick. It was easier. That was, you know, it was not that big of a deal. But I do recall, let's see. I think the incident went something like this. I have told you that I had two PE classes my senior year. And, I mean, yeah, I did. So, and one of my PE classes had to be lined up with lunch. And when you came out of the gym to go to the commons, if you turned left, you went to the commons to lunch. If you turned right, you went down the band hall into the student parking lot. So sometimes we'd get dismissed from PE class and we would forget to turn left and we would turn right and we would come to town and we would.
I'd assume these locations are the same that they are today. Right?
Absolutely. Okay. Yeah. We would get lunch and then we would come back. We went to lunch like everybody went to lunch. We just didn't have lunch at the same place everyone had lunch. So we were on Rock Crusher Hill coming back. It was Cole and Scott and I that particular day, and we were in Scott's car, and we met Teddy White, who was going to town, and we were coming back from town, and he saw us, and we had no clue but to wave and just go, well, hey. And so we got to deal with him later that afternoon, and he knew that Charlie Crane could pack a punch more than he could, so he turned us over to Mr. Crane, and
the rest is history.
The rest is history. And I have a story to tell for life as a result. So was it worth it? Sure, it was worth it. Still get to tell the story.
Dun, 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 dun. Plenty of questions that we can have on it.
Now, the first time was the story I told you about my friend Kevin, and then I think it was his last name was Pierce, and I can't remember his first name. Miss Juanita Morris sent us out to bang the erasers on the end of the fourth grade hallway. So, you know, in the old days with the chalk, you had to go out and bang the erasers on the side of the building against the bricks. So we were out doing that. And I was just going about doing our task, but I look over, and my friend Kevin and then our other cohort was over there. Well, one of them, of course, takes the eraser and bangs the other one on the shoulder or on the back. And he says, oh, yeah, well, I'm going to do that to you. And next thing you know, they're just waylaying one another with the erasers. And I am just watching. And Miss Juanita Morris comes out the door and sees this and drags us all into the hallway and paddled us. And I'm like, I was just out here doing what I was told to do.
So. You're still not upset about it, are you?
I got a story out of it. I got a story that I can still tell to this day. So, all right. So back to the question. Are they still paddling people in Kentucky schools?
I don't know.
I thought they were finished.
They should be.
But Maybe. I don't know. Maybe someone knows better than I do. I thought for a while, when they were in a transitionary period, if you were a parent and you would allow it, you had to go sign and
say it
was okay. But now it just may not be a thing.
I think I had to do that even with Anna. So
probably.
Well, I think the sheriff tells the story. I think Mr. McGee paddled him.
I can't imagine Mr. McGee paddling anyone.
I know. I felt like he had told that story before, though.
I mean, sure he has, but I just can't imagine.
I know. But that would be
heartbreaking, I would think. It probably would not be the paddling itself.
Yeah.
You disappointed him.
Yes. It would be the shame and disappointment.
Although, if you get to the point where he has to paddle you, it's probably going to be bad.
Yes.
Right?
You really screwed up. You've let 10 pigs loose in the school. Yes.
It'd have to probably be more than 10. Probably. You said something about the cougars, I guess. That would be his.
So I ran across this morning, and it's probably right on target. It says, as long as food does not smell bad, it's safe to eat, right? Well, no. Even if you have the world's most sensitive sniffer, smell alone isn't enough to tell if a food is okay to put into your mouth. Bacteria you can't see, smell, or taste are the most dangerous, according to health experts. Instead, your safest bet to avoid a night on the throne is to decide whether something is edible or not based on how long it's been around. If it sits out for more than 2 hours, you should toss it. Well, we ignore the 2 hours, but... We were in a situation yesterday where we had some leftovers from...
Don't tell how long.
From more than 2 hours ago. Mm-hmm. But I noticed, I thought that she had been into it, and I noticed I got into it, and I'm like, it didn't smell all that bad, but it didn't taste bad, but I noticed it didn't taste good. Like, this is not tasting what I expected it to taste like. But we both came to the same conclusion independently, right? So, but we apparently lived.
Yes, we did.
Right? So we made it through.
But we also have stomachs of steel, so.
That's true. Just because it smells okay doesn't mean it is okay. That's not the singular test to deciding whether you should eat something or not. Got to get to a break. We'll come back. Got more on the way here on In the Know.
Maxine the Vaccine and Max the Vax want to give you all-day ride passes at the Kentucky State Fair. Now through August 27th, be one of the first 150 people to stop by the Kentucky State Fair Horizons Health Pavilion. Get your child up to date on immunizations and receive all-day ride passes. Plus, you could also win gift cards. Visit KAHP.org for more information. That's KAHP.org. This message is sponsored by the Kentucky Association of Health Plans.
The Heiser Hearing Institute is here to provide the care and support you need. From hearing screenings and diagnostic tests to cochlear implants and balance treatments, the goal of Heiser Hearing Institute's Kentucky Hears program is to remove barriers and to provide equal access to hearing health care in rural Kentucky. Don't let hearing loss hold you back from living your best life. Visit kyhears.org to see when their mobile clinic is coming for a visit near you. That's kyhears.org.
Life can be full of risks. One thing you shouldn't take a risk with ever is your family's health insurance. If you're self-employed or you now need affordable health insurance, you need to make this free call right now and see how the Health Insurance Helpline can help you get it. We specialize in helping the self-employed and people just like you that need affordable health insurance to get it. We have short and long-term health insurance plans, and some even cover dental, vision, and prescription drugs. Don't take a risk with your family's health insurance. It's not worth it. If you're self-employed or now need affordable health insurance, call right now and learn for free how to get it. Listen, affordable health insurance plans for everyone just like you are a free phone call away. So give us a shout right now.
800-659-7540. 800-659-7540. 800-659-7540. That's 800-659-7540.
The Kentucky Department for Community-Based Services is hiring. DCBS invites you to be part of an inclusive team of caring professionals that helps all Kentucky families through a rewarding career in family support or social services. They have job openings in their county offices across the state and offer great benefits like hybrid work schedule, competitive salary, paid holidays, and many opportunities for training and promotions, plus state employee discounts. Go online to chfs.ky.gov and enter DCBS jobs in the search field. It's a new day at DCBS. Join them, an equal opportunity employer, MFD.
This is Kentucky, where the only thing ordinary is the unexpected.
I got everything you need.
Horse country, legendary distilleries, rivers to paddle, lakes to splash and relax, big city vibes, and small town charms. This is Kentucky. Come see for yourself. Plan your road trip at KentuckyTourism.com.
Hey, it's Ashley from 97.5 WAMC. Summertime is finally here. As traffic increases, the Kentucky Office of Highway Safety reminds all road users to pay attention and watch out for each other. Following the rules of the road and these simple steps can help save lives. Remember to buckle up every trip, every time. Put the phone down if you are driving, walking, or riding a bike or motorcycle. Safety is a shared responsibility. Enjoy your summer and be safe, Kentucky.
Hey, 105 Weather is brought to you by Future Designs Building Materials on Quarry Road in Litchfield.
Twin Lakes Weather.
This is day number 4 of the heat wave, and certainly one of the hotter days of the year so far. It could be matched at 96 degrees. It's not a record or anything, but day 4 in the 90s certainly starts to take a toll on you, so take it easy outside. We have a heat advisory in effect, also an air quality alert all the way through midnight with a high again of 96. Tonight we drop down to only 80 for the overnight low. From the Wave Storm Tracking Team, I'm Brian Good.
The 105 days of summer is powered by Litchfield Exterminating here on the Twin Lakes Best Mix, K105.
Did you know wind doesn't make a sound until it blows against an object?
Until you use me up. Well, so you have to break it, right?
When you hear the wind blow, that's right, you gotta crack it. You gotta, until it brushes up against something you don't hear.
That's how it works.
We just, talking about riding the wind, eh? Just thought I'd give you a factoid about wind. Are you working really hard?
Oh, yeah, okay. I'm really, because what I want to say, I don't.
Okay.
It's a family show.
Frasier Revival sets premiere date at Paramount Plus, and the first two episodes will air on CBS. So if you want to see the Frasier Revival, the first two episodes on October 12 in the U.S., and then the second will be... They'll air back to back on CBS on October 17th.
Wow! I know this 10 is episodes. The thing. What is he, a lawyer? Is he? What is he?
Radio host.
Oh, okay. See, I knew this is a thing, but I don't know that I've ever.
Yeah,
it's obviously was quite a bit before my time.
His catchphrase when he would answer a call, he would say, "Hello, son, I'm listening." Right, I'm listening.
Was it a good show?
Oh,
yeah, it was pretty good.
Yes.
Yeah. It's.
Big fan.
I did not really like his character on Cheers, but I liked his character out by itself. The repartee between he and his brother Niles was really good.
Oh, his dad.
And then the dad was the, you know, it was good. It was well done.
That's something I will be watching.
You know, in radio, you like it too, just because of the, but it was really not a whole lot about. It was not about radio like WKRP about radio. It was not about radio like news radio was about radio. Did you ever see that show?
No.
Phil Hartman. So Dave Foley from the Kids in the Hall. Phil Hartman was on there. Candy Alexander, who went on being the I think Candy Alexander's her name. She went on to be the medical examiner on the original CSI.
Yes.
And who Miami? Else was on there? Joe Rogan was on there. Andy Dick was on there. Mara Tierney, who was on ER, was on there. It was outstanding cast. And then Mr. James, the boss, he's somebody, I should know his name, but I don't.
News radio?
News radio. He's really good. So here we start talking about Frasier, and we ended up talking about news radio. It's some of Phil Hartman's best work. Really good. The Taylor Swift sphere, the Eras Tour sphere, has given us lots of good headlines.
Stephen Root? Is that who you're thinking of?
Stephen Root.
Jimmy James?
Played Jimmy James? Yeah. He was it was a really good show. And I bet it's on Hulu. No, I bet it's on Peacock. I bet it's where we could find it. So we've been given a lot of memes. We've been given a lot of stories because this traveling circus that the Taylor Swift Eras Tour is, you know, just generates this buzz in whatever town, stimulates the economy. Well, apparently there was a security guard who has gone viral because someone recorded him singing along with her.
Oh, he's getting down.
Yeah, so I've not seen it. But he's apparently just really into it. He's a security guard, etc.
He was having the time of his life.
And so he's gone viral, but then turns out he got fired.
Aw.
Well, he didn't get fired for singing along, but he did get fired because he was passing notes to people in the crowd asking for them to take a photo when she was in the background. So he was there more as a spectator. Like he became a security guard just for a ticket to the show. And so rather than being security, he was asking girls, like, take this. When she's in the background, take my photo and then so you can send it to me. So they let him go. And he said, there's no grudge. And basically, he was admitting, yeah, that's the only reason that I did the job was because I couldn't get a ticket to the show. So it was kind of funny. Taylor Swift, of course, famously left Scooter Braun after the blow up. We told you there are others that are leaving. Demi Lovato is leaving. Ariana Grande is leaving. Apparently, sources say the Braun people are trying to say that he's trying to take a step back from daily operations. But others are saying he's imploding. It's a different world since the pandemic. He said, you can't be a butthead like that anymore. So, I don't know.
Is that the word they call him?
No.
Oh, okay.
That's my word.
I was hoping that was the word that they used.
I mean, I would like it. I'm trying to encourage its use as much as possible. But Ariana Grande reveals that she got a Glinda the Good Witch tattoo. You know, she's going to be in the live-action version of Wicked. She'll be playing Glinda the Good. So she...
Is this a movie?
Yes, okay. It will be.
I know Wicked. I just didn't know that they were making a movie version of it.
Yeah, and I don't know who's playing Elphaba. I should know this, but I don't know. So, as far as...
I feel like she'd be a good... Ariana Grande would be a good Glinda, will. Though.
They did a special. I don't know if it was on the 10th anniversary or something. They did a special around Halloween a few years ago, and they brought Ariana on to sing a couple of the main themes from Wicked, and she slayed it. So I think that's one of the things that landed her the job. Now, I know that not everybody, you know, other people are talented, but I'll just tell you, I will never look at an Elphaba that's not Idina Menzel and not wish it was Idina Menzel. Like, she's just the original. But I am more forgiving of people trying to play Glinda and not being Kristen Chenoweth than I am of people trying to play Elphaba and not being Idina Menzel. I don't know why that is, but...
Cynthia Erivo. And I'm looking. She's not been in a lot. This looks like it's her first big break.
Well, it's funny. Rent, Idina Menzel, Rent landed her Elphaba, and then Elphaba just sent her into the stratosphere on. That led her to Frozen. That led her to playing Elsa.
Did you know who the Wizard of Oz is going to be?
The Wizard? No.
Jeff Goldblum.
Yeah, it'll be okay. Yeah,
he'll
be fine. We learned last week that Rumor Willis is a native Kentuckian.
Born in Paducah,
just because her parents were working in Paducah at the time that she was born. I think Bruce was filming a movie.
Correct.
And Demi was there with them, and she went into labor, so Rumor was born in Paducah. Well, Rumor is now a mama, and they named their daughter Luetta. Louetta. Come to find out, though, it was a typo. She and her husband were exchanging names via text, and he was sending Loretta. I don't know if it's an homage to Loretta Lynn, also famous Kentuckian, But for some reason, it was misspelled as Luetta. But as soon as she saw it, she decided she loved it. And it just stuck. It was Luetta, which really is a pretty name.
Yeah.
It is. I mean, Loretta would have been fine as well, but they probably just would have called her Retta, right?
Etta.
This little girl, they're going to call her Etta, I'm pretty sure. So it's pretty popular these days. We got to get to a break. We'll come back. Got more on the way here on In the Know.
How do we know when God shows up in our lives? Personally, I don't think you see lightning and thunder. I think you see ordinary people who give out of their abundance to help someone in need. Iconic comedian and actress Carol Burnett had something of a divine encounter after she graduated from high school in 1951. She dreamed of attending film school at UCLA, but her family couldn't afford the tuition. Her legendary career might never have gotten started if generous strangers had not reached out to bless her. Carol retrieved the mail one day and found an anonymous letter addressed to her. Inside the envelope was the money she needed to cover her tuition. A few years later, Carol had a similar experience. By this time, she was 21 and had completed film school, but her career was struggling to get off the ground. One night, a man in a tuxedo approached her backstage after a play and gave her the money she needed to move to New York City and begin her career. The rest, as they say, is history. People rank stories like that somewhere between coincidence and divine intervention. I guess we'll never know for sure, but I believe this. We often don't attribute our good fortune to God because we're watching for something spectacular to happen. God isn't found in lightning and thunder, but in every cup of cold water we give to someone who's thirsty. For more to help you thrive, go to FocusOnTheFamily.com. I'm Jim Daly.
Let's see, if something costs less, but people are happier with it, that sounds like something to look into, and that's MediShare. Maybe you've heard switching to MediShare to pay for healthcare can save the typical family $500 a month. And that's huge, but it's also true that people are way more satisfied after making the switch, too. The customer satisfaction rate for MediShare is double that of the typical health insurance plan. Double. MediShare works. It's been around for more than a quarter century, and members have shared more than $3 billion of each other's bills. People love having telehealth and a huge nationwide PPO network. So, yeah, you can save a ton and like it better. Imagine being happy with how you're taking care of your health care. So if you're self-employed or part of the gig economy, or you just want a plan you're happy with, you can call right now and get a price within 2 minutes. A very, very smart use of 2 minutes. Here's the number you need. 888-SHARE-19. That's 888-SHARE-19. 888-SHARE-19.
Are you looking for the best building materials in Litchfield? Look no further than Future Designs Building Materials. The Builder's Choice on Quarry Road has everything you need to build your dream home. Susan writes, I'm remodeling my kitchen and Future Designs had everything I needed. They even helped me design my dream kitchen. Thanks, Susan. Future Designs is more than just a building materials store. Future Designs Building Materials on Quarry Road in Litchfield. FDBM.net.
Building on experience.
MB's point to ponder for today. Rapid fire, would you rather?
Oh, gosh.
Would you rather have to shave your head or have to have your nose pierced?
Nose pierced.
I knew you would.
How
about you, Sam?
I guess shave it.
Would you rather live your life with tasteless food or without friends?
Tasteless foods.
I guess no friends.
Would you rather have a lot of time or a lot of money?
A lot of money.
Yeah.
Would you rather be trapped in a romantic comedy with your enemies or trapped in a horror movie with your friends?
I'll take the
latter.
The horror.
Would you rather have a hook for a hand or a peg for a leg?
Hook. Can I pick which hand?
Yeah, that's me. That's me.
Because here you go.
This is rapid fire.
If it's my left hand, then I'm not taking.
All right, I'm taking the peg leg.
Would you rather always wear comfortable clothes or always wear fashionable clothes?
Comfortable.
Would you rather date someone who won't stop talking or someone who won't stop texting?
Texting.
Yes.
Would you rather go on a liquid diet or a meat-only diet?
Meat-only.
Yeah, without question.
Would you rather have a huge booger hanging out from your nose for the rest of your life or a pimple on your forehead for the rest of your life?
Pimple on my forehead.
I guess.
Listen, Sam, I can hook you up with some makeup.
I guess.
Yeah, that's like,
right. We'll cover that up. They didn't say anything about covering it up.
So it's hanging out. It's not just a bat in a cave.
No, it's hanging out.
Yeah, hanging out. Today's highlight in history: this date, 1927, amid worldwide protests, Italian-born anarchists Sacco and Vanzetti were executed in Boston for the murders of two men during a 1920 robbery. Britain's King George III proclaimed the American colonies to be in a state of open and avowed rebellion this date in 1775. Yeah, we'll take that, King George. Oh, I forgot to say, in 1305, Scottish rebel leader Sir William Wallace was executed by the English for treason. They will never take away our freedom. Barry Obama named Joey B his running mate this date in 08. Barbara Eden is 92 today. I dream of Jeannie. Richard Sanders, Les Nessman, is 83 today. Shelley Long is 74. Rick Springfield is 74. Jay Moore is 53. Scott Kahn is 47. Scott Kahn was great in Hawaii Five-0 as Dano, but my favorite Scott Kahn role is Ocean's 11. Jamie Lee Kirchner is 42 today, and Jeremy Lin is 35. Sam, just because one person spurs a summer called Linsanity, do they deserve to be on celebrity birthdays for the rest of their life?
Yeah.
They do?
Yeah, I mean, heck, I could tell you where you... Do you know where you went to college?
Stanford?
You're in the right realm. Harvard.
Okay. Louis XVI, born in 1754. Gene Kelly in 1912. Tex Williams in 1917. Keith Moon in 1946. I thought there was one other that was worthy of mentioning. All right, let's go to chart toppers. 1962, Little Eva was number one. Everybody's doing a brand new dance now. Mama, baby. Do the mama motion. Let's go from 62 to 71. West Virginia. John Denver.
My mom's ready for this one. That's the native West Virginian. Life is old there,
older than the tree. You know the chorus. Let's go to 1980, Diana Ross and Upside Down.
I said upside down.
Let's go to 1989. Shenandoah number one was Sunday in the South. I don't know if I know this song. I know Shenandoah, but I don't know if I know this song. Mill worker
houses lined up. I've heard enough already. Another Southern
Sundays. I don't know that one.
Hmm.
And then
I think I was better off not knowing it.
Aerosmith from Armageddon, number one in 98. Big Girls Don't Cry, Fergie in 07. And Calvin Harris and Rihanna, This Is What You Came For, number one in 2016. New Mama again, by the way. Rihanna and ASAP Rocky had their baby earlier this week. So, MB's Pearl of Wisdom for today: never interrupt your enemy when he's making a mistake. Never interrupt your enemy when he's making a mistake. MB's Pearl of Wisdom for today: remember, God loves you and I do too. If you don't know Jesus, let me know and I'll introduce you. Look forward to seeing you back here tomorrow for another edition of our show. For Sam Gormley, for Beege, I'm MB, and now you're in the know.
Powering through the Twin Lakes with the best mix of music, news, weather, and fun. If it's in the Twin Lakes, it's